Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And today we are going to talk about how to create and use GIF animation files in PowerPoint. And here we have one of our presentation, and the tutorial of this animation will be released soon. And in this presentation I have used two animation GIF files that I also created inside the PowerPoint. And why I am using the GIF files in this presentation, I will explain you the complete topic and why would you need to do that. I will explain everything about that. So let's get started. And first of all, I will open the selection pane of this presentation to see all the objects that we are currently having on this slide. So here you can see a long list that we used to draw all these shapes. And along with the shape layers, as you can see here, we have used a lot of rounded corner rectangles and other shapes. Along with the shapes, if you look carefully, then we here have picture 18. So if I turn this off, and you can also note one thing that we are not seeing the slideshow, but still these two animation effects are still getting played, like this screen. The text on the screen and these music notes are still playing in the background, and that is because both of these are GIF files. So if I show you the slideshow, then you can see the complete animation. So why I'm using two GIF animation files here and how I had created them, that is the topic of this tutorial. So let me turn off this picture 18, and you can see that the music notes are now gone. And if I scroll up, then here we have picture 14. That is on top because the position of this screen is on top of all the other objects. So if I turn this off, then that text animation screen has also gone. So first I will explain you that why I need to use GIF files for this, and then later I will explain that how I had created them. So I have another presentation here. If you look into this presentation, I have named it screen. So if I open the selection pane here, then you can see that I have used a lot of rounded corner rectangles to create these text inside the screen, as you can see. And we also have a freeform shape, that is the outer line of the screen. So what we need, we want to display these rounded corner rectangles one by one. And if I go to the animations tab and open the animation pane, then you can see that I have applied the wipe animation with a very short duration of 0.10 seconds. And in very rare my presentation I use after previous, and I have to recreate this animated text screen because you cannot apply all these animation effects inside a single slide or a single presentation. So that is why I have to recreate this animation in a separate presentation, and then later I have exported this. So I am using the wipe animation effect, and if I show you the effect options property, then I am using the right direction here. So what I want each of this rounded corner rectangle to appear from right while having the wipe animation effect. So you can easily apply that. Let me delete all of them, and now I will select all of these rounded corner rectangles, and the best way to select them is to draw a rectangle to have all the shape layers within this selection, and they will get selected. And now if I go to the add animation from the animations tab, and here I go to the more entrance effect, and I will choose the wipe animation effect. So you can see the preview. Let's see the slideshow. So here you can see that all of them are coming at once. So what I need all of them to come one by one, so with a higher speed. And I will apply the time duration 0.10 seconds, and I will set them after previous. So the first rounded corner rectangle will appear with the wipe effect within 0.10 seconds from the right direction. Let me change the direction as well. You can select all the animation effects by selecting the first one, then holding the shift key, and then select the last one. And here now I will change the effect option from right. So here we have our animation. So now I only need this screen and the text with the animation. So you can go to the file menu and then click on export, and here you can find that option, create an animated GIF. And let me tell you that you might not be able to see this option if you are using any older version of Microsoft PowerPoint. I am currently using Microsoft Office 365 and you have to buy a monthly or yearly subscription for this. So if you have that option, then you can really create many attractive animations in PowerPoint by creating different segments of animation effects in different presentation and then export them in as GIF file, and then later import those GIF file into a single presentation to create a single animated scene like we have did here. So now I will click here create GIF, but before that I will also make a check mark on make background transparent. So I don't need any white or black background, I only need this screen here. So go to the file, export, create an animated GIF, and you can also choose the quality. Let's say we will go with extra large, then click create GIF, and you can see that I have previously exported both of these GIF files, text on screen GIF and music notes GIF. Let me name it screen 2 GIF and click save. And here you can see the status. So now what I can do, I can come back to this presentation and here I can insert that screen. And you can see that previously I have drawn all the shape layers on this presentation and had applied the same animation, wipe animation effect on this. But what I need to repeat this animation effect again and again. So if I show you the slideshow, then it is not moving now. So let's say if I select all of them like this, and now I can go to the animations tab, click add animation, drop down button and choose wipe, change the effect option from right and set it to play after previous with a duration of 0.10 seconds. And now we will open the animation pan and we'll see the position of these effects. Now all of these effects will play after all the other animation effects that I have used on this presentation. So as you can see, our last animation effects ends at 5.25 seconds. So that is why these animation effect will start after that. So if I set them to play with previous, then I can change the delay timing as I want. So I want to start all of these animation from the beginning of the animation. So now I have to manually add delay between each of the effects. Like here I have to set 0.10 second delay, and then here I have to set 0.20 second delay. So that way it is going to take a lot of time to apply the delay timings between all of these effects. However, I want the first effect to start without any delay from the 0 second. So we can't choose after previous in that situation, because if you will apply that, then it will start right from here. Or what you can do, you can also change the position of all of these effects. Like you can move them to the top and you can select all of them and can drag and drop them in the animation pan according to the position that you want. Like I want the top position for them. And now you can see that how the after previous is working. So now these effects will get played after this. So now you cannot move back from this point. You can see that the delay timing is already set to 0. However, this animation will start at 2.2 seconds. So that could be the situation when you need to create a GIF file for the specific animation that you want to use inside that presentation. The another problem here is that if I show you the slideshow, then you can see that all those text lines are playing, but they are playing only once. And if I select again all of them, like this, and go to the effect options and I ask them to repeat this effect until end of the slide, then it is not going to help, as you can see that here, because we cannot add a delay between the repeats. Like if I want to add a 1 second delay between the first and second repeats, so that is why I have to export this particular scene as a separate GIF file, and then later I have imported that GIF into this presentation, let me delete all of these shapes and then go to the insert, pictures, this device, and now you can import that GIF file that you exported in previous step, like here, screen to GIF. So as you know that the GIF files are played infinitely in Microsoft PowerPoint during the slideshows. So that way this effect will automatically get repeated until end of the slide. So the same way we want that for the music notes. We want the music notes to come from the down and go upwards again and again. And here you can see that I have applied 5 animation effect to a single animation note. So same way I placed these music notes on a separate presentation and applied all the animation effects that I want. Then I go to the file, export, create an animated GIF, make background transparent, extra large quality, create GIF, and now I will name it music notes 2. Let's say save, and now I will move back to this presentation. As you can see that we have already inserted that GIF. You can see that play and pause sign here. And let me delete this one, and I will also delete these notes here because we no longer need them. So I will delete all of them. Or you can also open the selection pane and you will see those notes as graphics graphics object here, and I can select and delete them right from here easily. And you can insert these music notes from the insert icons option, and here if you will type music and press the enter key, then you will start seeing the music icon which I have used in this presentation. And later after inserting one of the note, you can also use the graphic format options here, like you can change the fill and outline colors, which I did in this presentation. So now I will insert that GIF file as a background from this device, music note 2, insert, and I will also send, however this music note GIF file is transparent, but still I will send it to back behind all these objects because we want the music notes to come from the back side. So now if I see the, I will also insert that screen animation, screen to GIF, and the position is right here. And now if we see the slideshow, then both of these animation will play infinitely until end of the slide. So that is how you can create a particular scene in a particular presentation and then can export that as a GIF file, and later you can import that transparent GIF file into your other presentation as a separate running animation sequence. So I hope you get my point and you will also like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video, and you can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye and have a nice weekend.